Hello friends, Reed here. Welcome to a vintage gameplay video here on channelfireball.com. Today what I have for you is Beseech the Mirror. So this is a, I would call it like a hybrid of a combo deck and, well, I want to say, part of me wants to say control, but there's not really such a thing as control in vintage, just a hybrid of like a normal looking vintage value deck and a combo deck, using the powerful new Beseech the Mirror. So what can you do with this deck? Well, you have Urza's Saga, which can churn out giant constructs and win the game by attacking. You can assemble the Time Vault Voltaic Key combo. You can use Beseech the Mirror to go for a single powerful card like Necropotence or Tinker for Bolas's Citadel. Once you generate all this value, you can sit back and protect your position with Force of Will. Or you can go for a Storm combo kill with Beseech the Mirror for Tendrils of Agony. Often along the way, you'll use Yawgmoth's Will for that. So this is just a really high-powered deck with a lot of cool ways that you can go for the win, a lot of different directions that you can take the game. So I thought this would be a really fun one to run through a five-match Vintage League. So I hope you'll stick with me through those five matches. As I get into the games, let's just get this going. As I get into the games, I want to give a shout out to Ultimate Guard. It's really important to use quality when it comes to your valuable Magic collection, especially when it comes to older formats like Vintage and Legacy. And that's why I really trust Ultimate Guard. I use their Katana inner sleeves or their Precision Fit sleeves. I use the Katana or Cortex sleeves for my regular sleeves for two layers of protection. I trust, you know, the Sidewinder or Boulder deck boxes to carry around my deck. And I really have had a great experience with Ultimate Guard products throughout my Magic career. And I encourage you to check them out too, especially if you're a fan of older formats like Vintage, Legacy, and Modern. All right, thank you for being here. Thank you for listening. And let's see what game number one has in store for us. This hand is much too fair. I do not like the lack of power cards in this hand and having Beseech the Mirror with no way to power it out. That this is just going to have to get thrown back. All right, so what's going on here? We have a lot of colorless mana, Alorian Revealed, which can get an Underground Sea. I'm still kind of a ways away from casting anything. I mean, turn three, I can Beseech the Mirror. I'm already down to six cards. So let's say, like, I'm to bottom the Manifold Key and just plan on churning these into Underground Seas. I mean, it's pretty bad, but not as bad as going to five, I think. Not sure about these Lorien Revealed, or perhaps a mix of Lorien Revealed and Preordain would serve me better. I think I would like this hand more if I had one Lorien, one Preordain. Okay, so that's a plan. That actually makes this potentially work out. I can go for something on turn one. I'm expecting a counterspell here, but you gotta make them have it. Yep. Sure. Man, that's the hand I wanted to have. The Lotus Ancestral Flusterstorm hand. All right, just do your show and tell Atraxa and put me out of my misery here. This is going to be hard to rebuild from. Urza's Saga, go! So now with Black Lotus, I could go for Beseech. I'm sort of inclined to just make a construct and then I can get Key and Beseech for Time Vault. If I knew my opponent had nothing, I would just Beseech for Necropotence there. My Tinker's already gone, by the way. Or I guess Beseech for Yawgmoth's Will would be a win if my opponent had nothing. So I can Beseech away the Spirit Token, which is kind of interesting. Pretty sure I want to not make a construct here. Okay, we're all in. All in on Beseech for Time Vault. You might ask, Reed, why didn't you attack with your Spirit Token? Because I had one mana floating from Urza's Saga. I think I had an alternative line that was probably a little bit better, which was Saga Chapter 3 to go for Sensei's Divining Top, and then go for Yawgmoth's Will, and potentially I could find a counter disruption or another piece of action. Because I even talked through it, I said Yawgmoth's Will was lethal anyway, so I didn't really need to go for Vault Key. And I could have used my Urza Saga for a little bit more value. Right, I'm gonna concede this one. See if I would have found anything with the top. Moving to sideboard, we have a defense grid. We have a Thoughtseize. And that's all we have. We have Shouldred coming out. Dress Down's actually really good against Oath. Could cut Basic Swamp. Could cut Vampiric or Mystical Tutor. Cut Nile Spellbomb. Chain of Vapor. I guess I'll cut Chain of Vapor. Okay. So I have a Force of Will. I have an Urza's Saga, which on Chapter 3 can go for Black Lotus. But I am extremely vulnerable to Strip Mine. I know my opponent has Strip Mine. I'm not expecting them to have a lot of Wastelands. But then I'm also likely just doing nothing on turn 2. And then also this hand is not that good against Flusterstorm. But I don't have to go all in on Lotus. I can get like Mox Sapphire and play Ancestral if I haven't used Force of Will by then. I'm gonna try this. Caught with my hand in the cookie jar with the greedy keep. Yep. Well, this is a forced play because I won't get a turn 3 if I don't counter that. Alright, I found a source of black mana. Pretty sure I'm just going for this. Hey, it worked. I could go Tinker for Citadel, or I could just go Necropotence. I'm going to choose Necropotence, because for number one, I've already made my land drop. Number two, if my opponent actually is sandbagging a Force of Will, or actually more likely Mindbreak Trap, then the Tinker, I have to invest more. Whereas if they counter the Necropotence, I can at least still cantrip the Nile Spellbomb. And Necropotence should lead to a win anyway. I think I'm going to draw 10. Kind of unscientific, but generally you want to, like, a good target is to go a little bit above 7 cards, so that you can discard the useless ones and sculpt a really good 7. But, you know, you don't want to draw like 16, because then you're just being frivolous with your life total and you're gonna have to discard most of what you're drawing anyway. Interesting. So options for discarding would be like Swamp, Second Beseech, maybe Mystical Tutor, maybe some of these colorless Moxen. Thinking about Mystical Tutor, if I was to pair the tutor with the dress down, or just set up for a future turn. Well, why don't I keep these seven and discard these four? Actually, I'm not sure I need the Dark Ritual. But no, it's fine. Go with it. On my turn, I'll have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8, 9, 10 mana. More if I want to search for like a mana source with the Urza Saga. Wow, Flash is a lot better than Show and Tell here because I could have show and showed in the dress down. But yeah, no, I have no counterplay against that. So you get an Atraxa trigger. It's kind of like draw five, I guess. So you're gonna get Atraxa, Boseiju, Mox, Oath, and then your choice of three inst of these three instants. Brainstorm. So Atraxa, Boseiju, Brainstorm. In theory, they could have Force of Will, but looks like I'm gonna beseech away the spirit token again. I guess, spin the top and then draw into something with the spell bomb. Force of will ought to put this away. Replaying all of the mana sources. Beseech again, sacrificing the Necropotence, and then that'll be the lethal tendrils. I can even cast this Force of Will from my graveyard if I want. Okay, well, I got a win. That feels good. Any changes for game number 3? No changes. Interesting hand. I'm gonna keep it. Okay, opponent starts with 6 cards. Let's do it. Well, I was going to go for the Time Twister, but now having the Force of Will and Time Twister as my only blue card makes things somewhat interesting. Maybe just Vampiric Tutor for Necropotence and be on that plan. Also plays pretty well against a possible Flusterstorm. Necropotence is sweet because it doesn't get countered by Flusterstorm, doesn't get countered by Mental Misstep, doesn't get countered by Pyroblast or Hydroblast. So they really have to have force. You can even play around Mindbreak Trap too. Could also just get Ancestral Recall. I mean, that is often good enough. Much lower investment. Sure. Because then if the Ancestral fails, I can still go Black Lotus for hardcast Bolas's Citadel as a longer term plan. Some consideration to Ancestral in response, but I'm thinking about if they have Flusterstorm, I might want to Ancestral on their turn instead. So I'm just going to let this go. Null Rod. Well, we can't have that. Okay, so I Ancestral in response. They forced my Ancestral. So now I'm deciding, do I want to force their force, or do I want to force the Null Rod? I think I still want to force the Null Rod. Hoping no Flusterstorm here, that would be really bad. Considering just blind flipping the top, because if I hit a mana source, it's really good for me. Let's try that. So this time I have Citadel dressed down and, well, actually the Citadel has gotten a lot weaker now with the Necropotence already in play. Though Citadel top is not nothing. I think I'm going to draw, like, I'm thinking either 6 or 7 cards. I'll go for 6. Definitely keeping Saga, Time Walk. I can just cast the Citadel next turn. Guess I'll just discard Brainstorm. Feels a little strange, but discard Brainstorm when you have 2 mana open. But I want to keep the mana open for dress down. So I'm just going to cast dress down in response and then use the show and tell to put in Bolas's Citadel. If I didn't have Citadel, I could just let the Show and Tell resolve and put in the dress down. Right. So I'm going to play Urza's Saga. I can cast a Beseech for free, which I guess that sounds pretty good. Bargaining away the Necro. Really can't go too wrong here. I guess just Yawgmoth's Will. And I'll respond by casting Dark Ritual from my hand. That's probably enough. Now from the graveyard, we have Ritual, Lotus. And my opponent has conceded. So that was eventually going to lead to a Tendrils kill. I was just trying to, you know, play carefully, maximize everything, not somehow walk into a Mind Break trap, but that was going to be unlikely given the Force of Will that I could cast from my graveyard. All right, so hooray for Necropotence. I was able to beat Oath of Druids in 2 sideboard games. I'll see you for round 2. Hey friends, welcome back to match number 2. And, we got a Serum Powder gamer. In my previous Vintage video, I had a tough run against Bizarre decks. I said these are my Achilles heel. I never seem to beat them. So my opponent does a Serum Powder and then keeps their next 7-card hand. It looks like this is a classic dredge deck with Force of Wills. Meanwhile, what do I have going on? I have actually pretty slow draw. I can vamp for a Black Lotus, but then I have nothing to pitch to Beseech the Mirror. So that means my play would be just vamp for Ancestral. So that might be a hand that I could keep under normal circumstances. Like, hey, I have a Force of Will, I have lands, and I have a turn 2 Ancestral. But that's probably not going to be good enough against Dredge. I really need to just go for a turn 2 kill. However, if I just find any artifact in my top 2 card, I'm sorry, not top 2 cards, because my second draw is going to be whatever I vamp tutor for. If my first draw step is an artifact, I'm all set. But yeah, I don't know if I can justify this. Like, if I just draw a Polluted Delta for my first draw step, then I'm vampiric tutoring for Ancestral. I do also have a Nihil Spellbomb. I mean, that's probably not going to be good enough against somebody who keeps 7 as a Bazaar at Baghdad. Especially not on turn 3 or turn 2 on the draw. Look, I guess I can justify keeping this, because if I draw Urza's Saga, then I can sacrifice that to bargain. So it's really only like, I have 6 remaining non-Urza Saga lands, a couple Lorien Reveals that are bad draws, but there are a lot of things I could find on turn 1 that are helpful, and failing that, turn 2 Ancestral, and then maybe find some fast mana from there. I have Force of Will, so I'm leaning towards this being marginally better than Mulliganing to 6, though I don't love my prospects on the draw against a dredge player, keep seven cards. Dredge, usually like turn three is the crucial turn where they're either killing you or they're dealing a massive amount of damage or they're shredding your hand. So I really look for the turn two kills in this matchup. Discarded Golgari Thug, Prized Amalgam, Serum Powder. That's not the scariest. Grief Pitching Amalgam. I think I'm supposed to Force of Will that. Hollow One, Chalice Zero. I mean, that is, yeah, it's a good start. And I did find Urza's Saga. So now I could vamp for a Black Lotus. Go Black Lotus Beseech. I can't get Tinker. Necropotence is not necessarily the best because it involves passing the turn. Oh, I can't get Black Lotus anyway. It would be Dark Ritual. So it'd be like Dark Ritual, Beseech for, I don't know, Time Twister. Well, at any rate, Underground Sea, go. Okay, so draw step, dredge the Golgari Thug, mill into Grave Troll, Narc Amoeba, Creeping Chill. So as you can see, I'm probably going to survive this turn, but I am not going to survive turn three. But interestingly, they didn't do the Bazaar. So maybe they just have, well, they didn't yet do the Bazaar. I guess they're going to. Okay, fair enough. Dredge the Troll. Then there's no other dredger, so just draw two, discard three. They're only going to have one card in hand, so unless it's a Mind Break Trap or a Mental Misstep, should be more or less okay. But man, I mean, going for the Time Twister against a Chalice is not appealing because it guarantees that I can't have any fast mana. Maybe I have to vamp for Time Walk and then hope the Saga can sort of get cracking. I mean, that's awful too. I have no good options here. None of these zero mana cards do anything. Yeah, I'm kind of at a loss here. I'm just going to go for Time Walk and then hope that my draw step is something really, really strong. So I could, in theory, chain the chalice. So here I'm passing. I'm trying to make a construct and block the hollow one. So if my opponent just does nothing this turn, then I can survive. But unfortunately, they're going to get to see like 24 cards with, or 18 cards with their dredge. The first dredge didn't deliver anything. I'm not outright dead to this attack, but I still want to chump block because that allows me to survive a single creeping chill. One creeping chill. One creeping chill, I might be alive. All I have to do is overcome a 26-2 deficit through a Chalice of the Void and all these creatures. Dress down is not helpful. So if I get a Black Lotus, then I have access to 7 mana, but also nothing to sacrifice. But I could just... No, okay, so... Thinking about, like, if I get Black Lotus, then I have nothing to sacrifice to bargain. Well, I could cast the Dress Down. So if I go float mana, play my land, that's 4 mana, search for Black Lotus, 7. Cast the Dress Down. Chain of Vapor the Chalice, Beseech for Yawgmoth's Will, replay the Lotus. But I'm still not getting ahead. C- could beseech for Time Twister. I could also hope that I draw something off the Dress Down. So do I want to just cast Dress Down now and see what I draw? Get Manifold Key, then can't beseech for Time Vault. That's not going to work. I'm going to cast the Dress Down and see what happens. Because I get a draw and I get a permanent that I can sack to bargain. Okay, Dark Ritual. Now we're cooking. Now there might actually be something here. And I want to do this before Chain of Vapor so that they can't flash it. They can't throw it back at me. Okay, so 3 black. 5 black. Beseech with the bargain. Searching for Yawgmoth's Will. Well, let me actually think about this. So then I'm gonna chain the chalice. So I'm gonna have 1 mana floating, a land drop is 2, a Dark Ritual is 4, a Black Lotus is 7. Beseech again for Tendrils. Okay, so the Will is the 4th spell. The Chain is the 5th spell. Dark Ritual 6. Black Lotus 7. Beseech 8. Tendrils 9. My opponent's at 26. Can just do big tendrils and time walk. Well, whatever. Let's do it. Dark Ritual, Lotus, Saga. So Beseech the 8th spell, Tendrils the 9th spell. With the Black Lotus, I can cast either Time Walk plus Chain of Vapor or Dress Down plus Chain of Vapor. Which gets me to 11 spells. So they'll be down to 4 and I'll be up to 24. And I'll have an extra turn, but my tendrils will be gone. So then what becomes the plan after that? If I dress down If I dress down and hit a zero mana artifact, then I can chain my own artifact and win like that. What happens? Oh, what if I vamp? What if I vampiric tutor and then dress down into the card that I tutored for? And that card is a Mox Jet or something along those lines. Oh, I'm at two. I can't vampiric tutor. Holy cow. Man, just when you think you have a line. Okay, what if I play the dress down, then I beseech into another beseech? I think we're getting somewhere. Because now I'll have two enchantments. I found a beseech in my hand. So once again, Beseech for Tendrils is 10 spells. Chain is 11, but I need to get to 13. I want to say like Beseech for Mana Crypt, then bounce my own Mana Crypt, but that only gives me colorless mana and is therefore not helpful. So there's no huge mana thing that I can get. Like the best thing I can beseech for is just Dark Ritual. So, what about Demonic Tutor for Dark Ritual? That doesn't really get me anywhere. Beseech for Demonic Tutor. This is so hard. There's Time Twister as like a, if I'm just giving up on trying to win, I get Time Twister. So beseech into another beseech, we're up to 10. I'm gonna chain the hollow one. I was trying to respond to my own spell there, but I guess I didn't do that correctly. Yeah, so I could have gotten one more. I could have gotten up to 24 if I had ordered things correctly. I should have cast the Chain of Vapor at an earlier time. But yeah, I guess I did not get there. Who would think the difference between my opponent being at 23 and 26 would determine the outcome? I wonder if there's anything there. Man, with the Vampiric Tutor, I thought I was going to figure it out, but I'm at 2, so I can't cast Vampiric Tutor. I could have Time Walked and then done a non-lethal Tendrils. I could have gone for a Time Twister at an earlier time and just hoped to get lucky. So tough. Maybe if I had a Cabal Ritual in my deck, or another, like, you know, like a second Black Lotus. Obviously, that's not allowed, but just if I still had Black Lotus in my deck, maybe there was something there. Well, I succeeded in losing game one and taking 15 minutes off my own clock, so that's not exactly a great start. Yeah, they're going to replay the Chalice. I was trying to think if there's anything that can happen. Like, I draw a Time Twister, put the Time Walk back in my deck and draw that and, you know, play a Shouldred or something like that. I think I'm just going to scoop at this point because they replay the Chalice. Oh, man, so stressful. I wonder if there was a way there. So Mental Misstep is bad. I think I can go without the Chain of Vapor, even though it was kind of good that game against the Chalice. Do I need all of these Tinker targets? Maybe the Portal to Phyrexia is bad, and I should just be on Citadel or Sphinx. Cut basic Swamp. Or Lorien Revealed, Force of Will. Weirdly, I don't mind the Defense Grid. Necropotence can go, actually. Because I don't like Necropotence where I have to pass the turn. Okay, let's try this. Sure. Got a Ley Line and a Functional Hand. Maybe just win with Ley Line and Construct Beatdown. My opponent appears to have a 69-card deck after sideboarding. I wonder if that's intentional. It can't be correct with the with a bizarre deck to go above 60, right? Ooh, they do have a Force of Vigor. But they're waiting for me to play another thing, which I don't want to do. So if I go like Mox Jet, Land Cycle, then they'll kill the Mox Jet and the Ley Line. Maybe I'm supposed to just pass. Not that the Mox Jet is like the most important card in the world. I guess it's somewhat expendable. And they elected to not do the Force of Vigor. I hope I just draw an island, because then I go island, I have Flusterstorm, and then I can win the game. I wonder if Flusterstorm is better or worse than Force of Will in this matchup. I think it's close. So now this is odd timing, but yeah, this is kind of, I guess, what I was hoping for, that they would have to spend the Force of Vigor on only the Ley Line, leaving me with my extra mana intact. And yeah, interesting. I can't get double black this turn, but I can pretty soon just recast the Ley Line. Funny, defense grid is symmetrical, so my opponent's probably thinking like, I wonder who's advantaged with that defense grid coming down. They have Golgari Thug, Hollow One, Force of Will, and we don't know what else. Vintage is crazy. Like, this match has not gone on for that many turns. Like, what, you know, game one, we got three or four turns each, and this is turn two of game two. And yet we've both, I think rightfully so, taken a huge amount of time off the clocks. Okay, I love this. Getting my opponent to trade the Force of Will there. Then hopefully they don't do anything too devastating, and then I can just recast Leyline of the Void next turn. So Dredge Thug, you get a Narcomoeba, another Thug for activating Bazaar. All right, and they bricked on second Dredger, so no harm, no foul. There's an Icarid that can hit me a few times, but it seems like if I get the... All right, so there's an Icarid, and then Amalgam can come back. So, that, yeah, there's a real clock here, but maybe I can make some Saga constructs and fight back. Do not yet have triple black, but I will next turn. So say Icarid exiles Grief, bring back Prized Amalgam, hit me for 4 down to 14. Then you attack for 7, attack for 7, but I can have Constructs, I can go for something with Beseech. It's going to be close. I suspect the combination of Leyline plus, say, Tinker for Sphinx of the Steel Wind, that should be good enough. I took so long in game one, but my opponent's taking a long time now. It's possible I could even catch up on clock. Discard Silversmoke Ghoul, Force of Negation, and Wasteland. One card still in hand. So something better than Wasteland. It's a little bit intimidating. What could be better than Wasteland? Mindbreak Trap or Force of Vigor? Interesting. So I actually found third source of black mana. Yeah, Floating Colorless. I guess maybe Beseech for, so if I get Manifold Key and then Beseech, but then I want to Flusterstorm up. Okay, I'll just get Black Lotus. Land drop. Yeah, possible there's a better option here, but I just want to go quickly because I still have game three to win. So I'm going to go with this plan that seems fine enough, even though it's not perfect. This is going to take 5 hits to kill them because it's four hits to deal 20 damage plus the Narc Amoeba can block. But I just don't think there's anything my opponent can do. They would have to destroy the ley line and then overpower this, and then I can just Flusterstorm anything that would destroy the ley line. Activate Bazaar. Not sure what you can find. Hollow ones don't do much. I guess just desperately looking for a Force of Vigor plus green card. All right, so we go to game three with both players 6 minutes on the clock. That's probably to the advantage of my opponent because my combo takes a long time to execute. But if I can just go for another quick tinker, that will work well for me. I'm going to bring in a Force of Will and cut the Flusterstorm, even though the Flusterstorm was good for me. Yeah, let's do it. Maybe quick Shouldred. Ley line plus Shouldred. That's a good plan. There you go. That's a quick Shouldred. My opponent's still with the 69 card deck. They have Mulligan to 6. They have Mulligan to 5. Don't count the Bazaar deck out, though. I have no ley line. If they start with Bazaar, it almost doesn't matter how many cards they have. Okay, 5 cards. Discard Narc Amiibo, Grief, Force of Vigor, no Dredgers yet. Grief pitching Stinkweed Imp, Force of Will that. It's really lucky they didn't hit a Dredger because now they're going to have to take probably 6 damage off of the Shouldred. Well, they're going to have to take damage off of the Shouldred until they find a Dredger. And Big Mama's home. Yeah, like if they activate Bazaar and don't find a Dredger, they're pretty much just dead because they're going to take 6, then 4, go to 10. And if they have to repeat the process again the next turn, that's it. They don't have enough life for that. All right, they conceded. So that's me edging by Dredge, almost 3-0 if I could have found just a little bit more damage in that game one. But a scrappy, tough match nonetheless. I'll be back. All right, everyone, after 2 nail biters, I'm back for round number 3. And what have we here? I have a pretty reactive hand. Force of Will, Flusterstorm, Saga. Dress Down doesn't really go well with the Saga construct plan. What am I supposed to do with this hand? Because it's clearly a fine functional hand, but it's also clearly off plan, or at least off plan A with this deck. I mean, I think it's hard to justify a mulligan. So I'm going to keep it and I guess play turn 1 Saga. In, for example, Modern and Legacy, in Modern, I often try to not play turn 1 Saga because then on turn 2 you miss out on a construct. But in a format where A, there's fast mana so that you can sometimes make a construct on turn 2, and B, the payoff of chapter 3 is really high, like you get Black Lotus or Soul Ring or whatever it might be, then I'm a lot more interested. Should I just Force of Will this hollow one? I think I'm going to do that. Force pitching probably Dress Down or... Yeah, Force pitching Dress Down. This is one of the worst matchups for Dress Down because none of their creatures have any abilities anyway. Probably should have Lorien Revealed there. I don't really need to play out a colored land because I am only going to be needing Flusterstorm to protect my own stuff. Like, for instance, getting my 2 Sagas Force of Vigored, that would be something I would want to Flusterstorm, but just taking calculated risk there. No Dredger yet, so they kept 7 with Bazaar. I guess we're going to Island Cycle at this point. That's not a good draw, but I'm just very likely to Time Twister next turn anyway. Like, get Black Lotus or Soul Ring and Time Twister and protect it with Flusterstorm. Wow, did they not activate Bizarre? What the heck is going on? This is the weirdest dredge game I've ever played. That's not true. I've played a lot of very weird dredge games. But these have to be like pretty near to the two worst draws in the deck. I mean, I guess anything that I can't cast is going to be a bad draw. But that is just miserable. These are the cards that, like, it's the pain of playing a combo deck is you have to play a couple of slots for cards that are just really bad to draw on their own, whereas most vintage decks, they kind of have this combo stuff built in, but they don't actually play dedicated win conditions, sort of. All right, here comes the Ikarid to get me down to 16. Still no Dredger. All right, well, the good news is if I draw an artifact source of mana, then I have enough to Time Twister with Flusterstorm backup. That's the good news. You're gonna Noxious Revival your Strip Mine. I guess I should Flusterstorm this, just because, yeah. Flusterstorm that. Could just Chain of Vapor that, but the number of cards in my opponent's hand does matter because they're trying not to Bizarre too low on cards. They can have Force of Wills, they can have whatever. All right, at any point I could choose to go Dark Ritual Time Twister, but it just seems so likely my opponent's holding a Force. Just die into a 3-3 attacker. I think this is the turn that I'm going to finally Chain of Vapor the Amalgam, because if I take it, then it's really easy for them to set up a kill next turn with Ikarid. So kind of getting to that point where I have to act. Discard it. Wow, still no Dredger. Chalice zero, fine. I mean, I can't do anything about it. I'm not Dark Ritualing first because I'm expecting this to get countered. And yep, there's Force of Negation pitching Arc Amoeba, so I'll just pass the turn. The Shambling Shell, the first Dredger. So next turn, I can expect to take 9 damage because this Amalgam is going to come back at the end of my turn. I can make one blocker. All right, a Demonic Tutor. I mean, that's something. Yeah. So, tutor for Yawgmoth's Will, Dark Ritual, Yawgmoth's Will, Dark Ritual, land drop. Ten. So, Demonic Tutor, Dark Ritual, Yawgmoth's Will, Dark Ritual, Tendrils, that's 10. I can't use zero mana artifacts to help me. If I get Beseech the Mirror. That's not going to work either. I mean, Nihil Spellbomb keeps me alive in theory. Tinker doesn't work. Necropotence doesn't work. Shouldred, pretty thin. Time Walk, which then gets me Urza's Saga Chapter 3. All right. Yeah, Time Walk. Then I can at least get Nihil Spellbomb to not be dead on the board. But yeah, my opponent had a counter. I was not going to win anyway. So GG, and I'm down a game. I played this matchup already, so... know more or less what my sideboarding is going to be. Seven cards in. Necro out. Dress down out. Sensei's top. Flusterstorm. Chain. Misstep. Swamp. And Force of Will. Something like that. I think that's what I did last time. All right, ley line and some turn one action. My opponent serum powdered once and then kept their seven. I think I'm going to wait, because if I pass, I can, in theory, hard cast Force of Will. But more importantly, I get one shot at this, cracking the Lotus for triple black. And I would love to draw a blue card for my Force of Will before I go for it. All right. Pitch Noxious Revival, Force of Vigor targeting Leyline and Black Lotus. So that's a forced play, pun intended. All right. Well, now I have nothing, and if you have a bizarre, then you probably win. Seems like they do, because they kept their hand. Mm-hmm. It's a hard configuration of cards to beat. What do I need here? Probably just Ancestral Recall, maybe Tinker, Time Twister. Right. Heavy on the black cards. So that can net me mana, I guess. Only colorless mana. Unlocks Mox Jet as a potential card that I could draw. Or Time Vault, you know. I guess also, yeah, I mean, I'm thinking about like double blue for Force of Will, but that's not gonna come in an irrelevant time frame. So I only get one more draw step. Nope, no access to black man anywhere. So that is a ignominious end for old Reader Rabbit in this match. But I'll be back for match number four. I hope you will be too. All right, everyone, welcome back for match number four of this Vintage League. And I have some potential here. I'm on the draw with a Force of Will, and I'm one mana away from a turn one Tinker. So gotta keep this one and see what the top of the library delivers. At worst, turn three, I have Urza's Saga Chapter 3 coming off, and then I'll have extra mana, extra material to use for Tinker or Beseech. Okay, so another Urza's Saga deck, and this player does not have Lurrus. Yep. Okay, so Moxjet, Dark Ritual, Beseech for Necropotence, and use Force of Will to protect it. I think that's the plan. Beseech with the bargain. Casting Necropotence. So, again, I want to draw a little past seven cards. I have, I'd say at least three that I'm perfectly happy to keep. So I don't need to go crazy, but I think drawing like five or six is probably appropriate. Let's draw six, and I'll try to have a perfect hand, but still enough life that I can necro back up on a future turn if the game goes long. Okay. So we're certainly keeping the Mox. If I discard the Tendrils, it's gone forever, which is not, it's not like I can't win if that happens, but it is somewhat inconvenient. I guess I can probably get rid of the additional Beseech, keep Demonic Tutor because it's a little bit less of an investment. Four, five, six, seven, but I want to have blue mana. So, like, these two are on the chopping block, and I need to discard one more. I'm not intending to cast Time Twister, but by keeping that for Force of Will, lets me, potentially cast the Tinker. Yeah, this is fine. I guess I'll just discard these three. Yeah. So Grim Monolith means they're pretty dedicated to the artifact thing. Okay, double Manifold Key, very dedicated. They have access to a ton of colorless mana plus the Black Lotus, but looks like nothing to do with it just yet. So here I'm skipping my draw step. I'm going to fetch Underground Sea and attempt to tinker. If they didn't have a counter last turn, doesn't stand to reason that they'd have multiple counters now. Okay, so I'm gonna get Bolas's Citadel with 12 life. And in some ways, Bolas's Citadel is bad with Necropotence, but in other ways, it's good because Necropotence, I can just clear the top card of my library for one mana any or for one life anytime I want. So 5 life to draw 3 or 1 life to just clear this. I'm gonna clear it. Okay. Well, I don't want to get myself in a spot where I'm dying to the Mana Crypt. Okay, so what happens now? If I'm Mystical Tutor, that'll be the seventh spell. I could put a Dark Ritual on top as the eighth spell, and then Tendrils should probably get me a win from there. I could also get Yawgmoth's Will, cost me more life points. I'll just stick with the Dark Ritual plan, that's fine. So now I'm going to cast Demonic Tutor from my hand. Get, whatever Black Lotus or another Dark Ritual or Yawgmoth's Will, any of the above. Okay. So I still don't know exactly what my opponent's up to. It could be, I guess, a Jewel Shops deck. The only lands that I saw were Talarian Academy and Urza Saga. I did see Force of Will, but I didn't really see any other colored cards. They clearly have a want to generate tons of colorless mana. So yeah, I guess I'll put them on Jewel Shops. Had a sideboard for that matchup. Not 100% clear. My instinct would be that I want Hurkle's Recall and Thoughtseize, and maybe not too much else. There's like Mystical Tutor, Vampiric Tutor. I'll keep the Chain of Vapor in. Not sure about Mental Misstep. Not sure about Dress Down. Not sure about Shouldred. So last few cards, we have Tutors, Dress Down, Shouldred, like an additional tinker target, defense grid. I think I'm going to skip defense grid because I'm worried that if I have to cast this and pass the turn, I could just die. Like it seems to be basically a combo mirror where we both have Force of Will. So I'd much rather go with stuff like Thoughtseize and Flusterstorm to win the battle. I guess I'll just keep these tutors. And then as the last card, do I want one Shouldered or one Dress Down? One Shouldered, please. Well, this hand can tinker on turn one. No, it can't. No, it cannot tinker on turn one. All right. Well, Urza's Saga go. Well, at least it looks like my opponent can't do much to follow up the Trinisphere. So if I can just make my land drops. So let's say, for the sake of argument, I get Soul Ring. Ooh, I might not get that far. Yeah, I can't do anything. I can't cast any spells right now. Coveted Jewel. So anyway, end of turn land cycle, untap, tap this for colorless, get a Soul Ring, play my land, I'll have 5 mana, still not enough to cast 2 spells. But my opponent seemingly can't interact with a Trinisphere and only 2 mana. Well, I've drawn the Bolas of Citadel, so that takes Tinker out of the equation. The Citadel wouldn't necessarily have been that great against Trinisphere anyway. What could I do? I could Beseech, but I can't play the spell off of the Beseech. So it really looks like I can't do much of anything besides just like Demonic Tutor and put Hercule's Recall in my hand. Or wait, can I tinker for Time Vault? Let's see. If I get Manifold Key, then I play Underground Sea, I make 3 mana. Yeah, there's no way I can get 2 artifacts on the field because I would have to sacrifice the key to cast the tinker. So I'm really just seeing like Sol Ring, tap three for Mox Emerald, tap three for Demonic Tutor, and put Hercule's Recall in my hand. And go. Probably dead. Opponent untapping with six cards and seven mana, and they are much better at operating through Trinisphere than I am. Well, in theory, I could Force of Will now, but I don't have one, and my opponent has 15 cards in hand. I guess they had 16 at one point. Okay, I think that's enough for me. 20 cards in hand and I'm defenseless. Any changes for game three? I mean, Shouldred is like... The problem is they're going to be at 20 when I cast Shouldred, so... I don't know how strong that's likely to be, whether I'd rather, I don't know, Mystical Tutor and Vampiric Tutor get Hercule's Recall, which is powerful in the matchup. Shouldred could be good in a Trinisphere type of game. Maybe I want it over the fourth Beseech or something. Probably not. Probably just one Shouldred is enough. Here we go. So Emerald, Lorien Revealed, play a land, Mystical Tutor. I also can just have the Mystical Tutor for the Force of Will and then plan to tinker. That seems better. Playing the Mox just in case they have, you know, Chalice Zero or Trinisphere or any of those other things a workshop's deck can do to annoy you. And here we go. You know, I could get Time Vault and just have Force of Will and win next turn when Urza Saga pops off, but I feel like if I get two turns with Bolas to Citadel, I'm effectively guaranteed to win anyway. And there's the Time Vault, so I got that for free. But I did make my land drop, and you're really likely to win if you play Bolas of Citadel on a turn you haven't made your land drop. If you have made your land drop, you can get stuck, but this time things seem to be going really nicely. And I picked up blue mana so I can Mystical Tutor this away. So if I play Shouldred and then play Tendrils, there'll be a Tendrils for 18 and a Shouldred on the battlefield. Of course, I could just get Beseech the Mirror. Yeah, that's I'll get Beseech. Seems like they don't have any counter. Well, that was a quick one. All right, 3-1 with Beseech the Mirror. I'll be back. All right, friends, welcome back to the fifth and final match of today's Vintage League. I'm 3-1, hoping to end on a positive note. Fortunate enough to get to go first. And my hand here is interesting. I have mana and a Time Vault and a Force of Will. Problem is, this hand doesn't actually do anything. Like the Tendrils and the Time Vault are win conditions that don't really progress my game plan when they're on the battlefield. So, really, what I have is some mana and a Force of Will. And I don't even have three black, so a lot of my best payoff cards are not really available yet. I don't think I can keep this. There's just too much risk of doing like stone cold nothing. It's also not a great hand against a wasteland. Ugh, feels bad to mulligan a hand with, functional hand with lands and spells. And this is why, because now I have a hand with no lands. Granted, I have Dark Ritual, Necro, Force. So if I just draw one land that produces black mana, it's a great hand, but I don't have a lot of those. I have nine black producing lands, plus four Urza Sagas, which take a long time, plus three Lorien Revealeds, which I can't land cycle, one Black Lotus, one Mox Jett, one Lotus Petal. So there's like 12 things that give me immediate black mana. I don't know that I can justify this one either. It's too, again, too big, too much risk of doing nothing. So here I have five cards. Again, no turn one mana source. But I have Misstep, Force of Will, Ponder. Do I just keep all the blue cards? All right, I got five cards and I end my turn. Great start. Funny, I opened on that, that flawed but potentially keepable seven card hand, and then things just got worse and worse with each mulligan. The good news about this is I can draw a source of any color. So I can draw like a Mox Emerald, or I can draw an Urza Saga. And there you go. I'm psychic. I'm gonna shuffle. That's my win condition. I was going to say I'll force their next play and just hope to win with seven mana crypt flips. But now they have cavern, so the force of will plan is out the door. So, force of will goes away. And manifold key goes away. I think that's right. The only real downside is if I draw exactly Time Vault. But I think the land is more likely to have long-term value. Keeping the land lets me cast a Lorien Revealed or a Bolas's Citadel. Also, I'm facing a Wasteland deck, so there's that to think about. Sure. Okay, they hit Ancient Tomb. I am not going to live long enough to see chapter 3, so I'm taking 10 damage this turn from trap plus another 5. And yeah, can't block Seasoned Dungeoneer because it gains protection from creatures. So what are my outs? Time Twister. Nope. GG. Okay, so I have some additional Tinker targets. I'm not going to bring in Tabernacle. Hercule's Recall is... Oh, hey, I just realized something. Was I bringing in the Pithing Needle against those Dredge decks? Because I might have just totally spaced that, but that's what it's there for, is... Like, I put it in my sideboard for Bazaar of Baghdad, and then I might have just overlooked it when I was sideboarding. If I did, and you're watching this video, and you decide to copy the deck, you want this against Bazaar of Baghdad decks, just to be clear. Anyway, tuning back into the match in question, Hercule's Recall can be okay, because they're going to have Null Rod and, like, Chalice, a small amount of disruptive artifacts. Shouldred's good. Solrend is good. That's what it's there for. Cutdown is good. So I'm thinking these are my slam dunks. Can probably take out the Bolas's Citadel. What else? The Sensei's top. The Nile Spell Bomb. Flusterstorm. Mental Misstep. I like the Chain of Vapor. I like the Dress Down. The Necro is less than perfect because you have to pass the turn. So I need one more cut, or I could just not bring in the second Hercule's Recall. Yeah, I think that's fine. One Hercule's, one Chain. Can't mulligan, but this hand is pretty bad against a Wasteland. Land, please. Land, please. Nope. So do I play Mana Crypt? Or do I just start discarding the hand size? Interestingly, a lot of the cards that I would have Beseeched for, I just have in my hand. Like, it's basically Tinker, Time Twister, or Necropotence. I boarded out the Necropotence. So I maybe could just discard this, and then if I draw a source of mana that produces black but not blue, then I can just power out the Shouldred and hope that works out. Well, I guess that's a reason to play the Mana Crypt. Gross. All right. I can't even force that because the Thalia. Oh, ugly, ugly, ugly. Everything was just really awkward in this match. Granted, the job of the mono white initiative deck is to make everything feel really awkward. But yeah, like lots of demanding colored mana requirements with lots of colorless mana, very vulnerable to wasteland. Not a stellar showing, I would say. And I'm inches away from reaching for the concede button. So this is going to end as a 3-2 league. I do hope you enjoyed this. I'm having a lot of fun bringing you vintage content. And yeah, I'll see you next time here on channelfireball.com.